Anytime you're talking about the Jesters, you got to start with Teddy Page. I mean, he was a outstanding guitarist and a very unique individual, just completely one of a kind. And he was a very much of a blues fanatic, I would say. It's probably the wrong word, blues lover. And he had a blues background, basically, and that's the type of guitar he basically played. But he transformed that during that period of time into really a harder, rocking, edgier sound.
Where and how did Jim Dickinson come into the picture?
Well, you know, in my mind, it's a little bit of a muddy situation because I don't exactly remember what the exact sequence of that it was. Knox actually was producing that record. I think it's been said that Sam was the producer on that record, but Knox, my brother, is actually the producer on the record. Anyway, I think Jim Dickinson was called in to put a little harder edge on it than what we were getting. When Dickinson came in and brought his piano playing style to it, it changed considerably from what we were doing. And I don't know that it was any better. It was just a different version of that song, but I think it turned out really great.